All right, everybody, welcome back. So at this point, we are going to clear out. Actually, we're going to go visit Queequeg first. Oh, that's to the mines. This is Queequeg, okay. Nope. Let me talk to you. Don't know how to tell him that you screwed me. Check one more time. He is supposed to sell me these gloves that I've been wanting, and I just can't seem to find them. Nope. More cure gauntlets. Well, I guess we'll go down to. Let's see, we need to go up to the spire. Okay, this one I think is the spire key. Make that big long detour just to get this open. And this is the other key of spades. This room is barren and quiet, looking quite undisturbed for over a century. As you cast a gaze about the chamber, you notice an eerie glow beginning to congeal within its center. Taking the shape of a human figure, soon you can discern a face, old and withered, and now it begins to speak. Hello, hello. Is that you, Annie? I can't see you, Annie. Can you hear me, Annie? Annie. Why do you not speak to me? Why don't you remember me? Annie, do you remember? Don't you remember who I am? I am. I do not remember. Yes, I remember a long time ago. I was a holy man, a pious and revered man. Remember Annie, sweet Annie. Oh, my Annie, are we? I'm punished, punished. Our daughter, we must hide our little girl. We must take her away. No, she is the devil. Oh, she was conceived from sin, from our sin, and she is damned. And it's okay, sweet Annie. The king has found us. The king has turned over our daughter. Wow, that's fast. You can read it. You have to pause it. Okay, it looks like he's gonna give us a horn. Goodbye, Annie. I am stepping into the light. Horn of Souls. All right. That was quite an endeavor. That is the end of the castle. I think next time, if I play this again, I'm gonna kill Queequeg. Because if he's not gonna give me
Oh.
those Seamus gloves, then there's no reason to keep him around. Once I've got the gear, once I respec and I've got the gear that I need. To the bottom floor of the castle. And now we are at the holding a pair of jewels, which we now have. Let's get them out of our bag. The two ruby eyeballs, the one that we got from the demon at the top of the Amazulu pyramid, and the demon at the top of the mountain, or the rock god at the top of the mountain. All right, use Minerva. A black steel skull cast out upon the face of the massive door stares blankly out into the corridor. A glowing gem rests in one eye socket, the other is empty. Well, let's fix the other one. A glowing gem rests in each eye socket, giving the skull a demonic face and sinister smile. Now we are at the River Styx. Stepping into the open air, your nose detects the scent of water, as if you were near a lake or something. And then you see it, surrounding your rock ledge, winding as far as the eye can see into an underground cavern in all directions, and then disappearing into the mists. All right, so. This is the River Styx. You first, a part of it, you have to use the ferryman, who is an undying NPC. You can fight him. If you kill him, he will respawn, so there's no harm done. I am going to try to fight him, just so you can see, because I'm probably going to die. A circular emblem is engraved upon the floor, adorned with many strange runes and mystic symbols. Inside the circle, a scene depicts a boat carrying a tomb in flames across the water. Right, we are going to use our Horn of Souls. The horn issues a haunting call, which echoes far across the water. Eventually, the echoes fade away, and only the quiet rippling of the river is left to fill the silence. From out of the mists, a dark figure slowly emerges. Riding atop a long, slender boat, he gently guides it to the shore. I am Charon, Ferryman of Ashes. Have you any ashes for me? No. Do you wish passage? Yes. The fee is 500 gold. Will you pay? No. All right, we're gonna fight. Let's see how bad he does. turns us to stone immediately. Wow. Okay. Yeah. Not good enough. I'm gonna try to kill him though before it's all said and done. That was pretty epic. Do you have any ashes for me? No. Do you wish passage? Yes. Fee is 500 gold. Will you pay? Yes. All right. Now he's going to take us to this little area down south, the Isle of the Dead. And the Isle of the Damned. Okay, that's just telling him that's where we can call him. Alright, this has another super fountain on it, by the way. So if you needed to, resting at the foot of the gate, you find a book and a key. Book of the Damned, Key of the Damned. Okay, so we're going to use the Key of the Damned. No effect. Do we have another key?
Ow.
Right. Let's review the Key of the Damned, the Wizard, the Book of the Damned. Use. The curse of the Minos. He who dwells upon the Isle of Minos is doomed by the curse of Minos, and shall become manifest in the form of a daemon. He shall be given the knowledge that his freedom lies with the destruction of others, and thus shall he live out his days, forever imprisoned, awaiting one with whom a battle may be fought and won, and in his triumph be released from the sad curse upon him. Never shall he know that it is only by the victory of an enemy, who shall knowingly risk life to destroy his, that his freedom can be won, and such an enemy in victory may suffer himself in the deed. Right. So let's go see if this key can open up these doors. It can. Let's see what awaits us. Night Gaunts. Okay, this is where stuff starts getting real.
Ow. Ow. Ow.
Nodachi, male mittens, cure paralyzed, cylinder of ash. Okay, Nodachi we already determined was not good for us. The male mittens probably are. Cure paralyzed, no. Cylinder of ash, that is a quest item. Okay. Male mittens are going to be better. Let me check how many cure gauntlets I need to bring with me in the next game. One, two, okay, so just two pair. And I'm pretty sure all my Valkyries have a pair currently, in addition to the Samurai, which is going to keep them. Yep, okay. So I'll give that to Cobra to sell. Because you have a pair, and you should be wearing a pair. Yes. Okay. Fully silenced. Wow.
Ow.
those. Let's get that artifact skill up. That fight alone should convince you that silence is a must-have spell. Oh, crap. Let's see if we can't just end this. Okay, so the unaffected is probably because I didn't cast it at a high enough level. So we're starting to get into the point where level 1 spells can be resisted. Go ghost, just take them all out single-handedly. See if deadly air works on these guys.
Ow.
I'm just trying to rest a little bit, people.
Ow.
back up. Probably gotta do it from the other side. And I bet, does this do anything? It does! Outside the gate, a raft made of heavy planks is floating in the water. There is a heavy steel cable attached to the wall, which then runs into and around a spool and crank device aboard the raft. Let's leave it alone for now. Let's finish the other side. These dudes.
Ow.
Alright. How are you doing in your skills? Almost up there.
Ow! Ow!
Let's see if that used it up. Yes, it did. Okay, so that's all of those. A thousand lambs shall be slaughtered to create the emptiness which from I moves death to lift the bane of Minos. All appeals to live, in peace to die. Alright, so we're going to... you'll do fire shield. And you will do a deep freeze. Do you have deep freeze? Yes, you do. Yes, you do. Yep. And you do not. So you will do a magic shield. Or magic screen.
Ow, 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 ow. Ow, 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 ow.
Even as the dust settles from the dead Mino demon, a ghostly visage appears, the soul of a man once held captive by the curse of the Isle of Minos. They has released me. For years I have been trapped upon the Isle of Minos, cursed not by the deeds but by words. Mine was the crime of spoken murder, for I did slay another by word alone, and with word alone did he die. As surely as if I had wielded a sword, his eyes did turn dull and glaze over. His mind ceased to function, and warmth drained from his smile. In that single moment I first said, believe, for as the essence of a man is born unto wonder, and his young eye lofts above meaning, long shall he live that can see things anew, where knowledge serves life and not points of view. On that day, when I first spoke of truth, when did I die? This, that was me. And only the fading echoes of thoughts, thought long ago, did serve as the reminder of life once remembered. Such was my crime on the Isle of Minos, a lesson of distant voices which hearkened blackened water. A blessing be upon ye, ye who look anew, leave curses for thy empty, the feeble blinded who must sayeth true. Of Minos, a studded Hallbrook. Alright, a key of Minos. A studded Hallbrook is good. That's usable by a lot of stuff. A Beastmaster. I think that's two-handed, but I'll take it. Alright, so key of Minos goes. How big is Cylinder of Ash? 1.5. Okay. So I bet you it's the Beastmaster. Six. One-handed. Fighter Valkyrie Lord. Okay, let me check that. Beastmaster 5 to 15. Yep, okay, that's better than the one I've got. So that's the one I'm going to use. Alright, so equip Beastmaster. And I no longer need my Sword of Striking. Oh, is he full? Yep. Cobra is full. Jellyfish. Yeah, let's just go ahead and nuke them down. So is this the key of Minos? It is. Almost getting through all my artifacts. I have to check Hildur's artifact skill at the end of this. So the fountain on the left, well, one of these, I think the one on the left is the one that does hit points and stamina, and the one on the right does magic. But we'll check. Okay, that one's hit points and stamina. And here's the spell points one. Which Wizardry 7 has a third bar to show you spell points, so it's much easier to figure out if you're full or not. but Wizardry 6 unfortunately did not have that. That's probably good enough. We're going to be coming back here quite a bit. The small underground mausoleum smells of mold and ferment, and perhaps a bit of stale corpses. Your intrusion feels to be the first to disturb the rotting languor after many years of peace. Don't have that yet, don't have that yet. Lots of zombie guards. Let's just take them out. Brute force this stuff. Whoever fires first. Cupid arrow, lance, ground shield, tomb key. Let's see if I can get anything better than that. Ooh, another heater shield. That is definitely worth considering. I think I will take that. Okay. Well, while I'm here, let's check. Mason Flail 85. Ninjutsu 64. Mason Flail 98. Almost there. Cobra. Mason Flail 85. Ninjutsu 69. Ninjutsu 90. Ninjutsu 65, one and dagger 87. Actually, let me go back up and just heal that way. Rows of stone sepulchres dot the room, private memorial chambers of the dead. Curious that such an arrangement might exist in a place known as the Isle of the Damned. Oh, nope, don't want to rest. Alright, so now, let's see which one of these. Mad Bomber, Ira Robbie. Killer with a cause, killed mostly children. Grandfather Ira Robbie would die for cause, killed millions instead. Okay, the blind is going to be a problem for me. I guess I'll just have to clean this up with nuclear blasts. Actually, no, I can use the deadly poison on these guys. Say that. Do I push Skullduggery further? Jinsu should rise on its own. Let's get this up. Levitate. huge spiders. I hate spiders. Poison and webbing. Oh man, that's a nice combination. See how bad the webbing is, or the poison is, I should say. Okay, poison's not that bad. Good. You have disturbed the bones. Oh no! That takes care of all the guards. So what do we have here? Nope, you don't have Dispel Undead. And those probably won't work. Ice Ball might. Do you have, yeah, you've got Dispel Undead. How about you?
Ow, 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 ow. Ow, 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 ow.
There we go. Coxcomb, Devil's Pipe, Acid Bomb Potion. Okay, the Coxcomb. I can't remember if that's a quest item or not. I'll hold on to it just in case, but I'm pretty sure that's not. The rest of that is throwaway stuff. Bully, big bossy, very well respected. They shot him 237 times. I disturbed the bones, oh no! Alright, so this one. Nuclear blast. Nuclear blast. Nuclear blast. Nuclear blast. And just go ahead and dispel undead for bully. Immediately.
Ow. 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 Ow.
Resurrection potion. That's at least better. Minerva's holding those for us. About good enough for one. Oh, shoot. I didn't mean to do that. Well, let me just finish this, I guess. Mace and flail 100. Okay, so let's redo these while I'm here. Okay, say coxcomb AC3. Yeah, and am I allowed to drop that? Let me save real quick. I am. Okay, so I definitely do not need that. Trade to Hilder. That. Alright, so now. View Minerva. Let's unequip all this stuff. And trade to Eagle. Pretty much everything. To Minerva. All that other good stuff. trade to Minerva the loot. Put that in your bag. Alright, so you're already at Mason Flail 100. Yep. So time for you to use the Spear of Death. And that's what makes the Spear of Death so powerful. It is a extended range weapon that is a one hand. And it's got pretty good damage on top of that. But just the fact that it's a one hand extended range weapon, that alone makes it pretty powerful. Trade those over to Blade. And I also did not end up needing the eye patch for anything, so I can sell that off here soon. Oh, I forgot to check to see if you could use the studded Hallbrook. You can! Invoke the power of your Ruby Talisman. No. And it's the studded Hallbrooks that I'm going to take into the next game. Yes, I'm not going to take in the leather Hallbrook, so that can be sent as well. Trade to Hildur. Okay. So you're under carry capacity, you're under carry capacity, you're under carry capacity. You're also full. I'm going to need to visit a vendor soon enough. Hoarder. Eagle. Alright. Save. Alright, that does it for this episode. Thanks for watching. See you next time.